conduction through your bones. Sounds shocking, right? Here are 10 things to consider when buying bone conduction headphones. Goedendag, we're DHRME. Devil headphones ring midnight earth.
In short, all the other headphones or earbuds you use essentially work using air conduction, meaning that the audio travels through the air, through your outer ear, then through your middle ear, and finally it reaches your inner ear. Bone conduction headphones sit at your cheekbone and conduct audio via vibrations and sound directly to your inner ear. And although it sounds dangerous and ripe for conspiracy theory,
so once I tried bone conduction headphones, right? And now my bones, they conduct music. I'm not kidding, check this out. You hear that, right? You hear?
They're just as safe or dangerous as any other form of sound. Higher volume, always dangerous.
If you've been following this channel for a while, wait, you're not a subscriber? How are they not a subscriber?
Well, that's an aftershock. Please hit subscribe.
Our opinions in this video are based on the AfterShokz Aeropex and OpenMove, kindly sent to us by AfterShokz, but as you're used to by now, this is an independent review. Full disclosure in the description.
All right, let's get one thing out of the way first. Do not buy bone conduction headphones for awesome sound quality. I mean, sure, you can hear the bass, the mids, and the treble, but overall the sound is a bit more limited and a bit dull in the treble regions. A common misconception also is that you do not have any sound leakage from bone conduction headphones because the audio travels magically through vibrations, but this isn't completely true either. At higher volumes, someone standing near you would be able to hear some sound, but it's not as bad as open back headphones or good old speakers. Good sound quality is usually achieved by several aspects, and one of them is the seal you create in your ear or over your ears, which bone conduction headphones unfortunately do not and cannot do. These sound closer to good laptop speakers or phone speakers with significant variability depending on where you place them.
Having said that, if you have a hearing impairment to your outer or middle ear, then using bone conduction headphones can bring you relatively better sound quality than ordinary air conduction headphones. Since bone conduction headphones keep your ears open, AfterShokz also includes foam earplugs in case you're in a safe space and want to block out ambient noise. The headphones come with an open ear EQ setting, and you can change this when you use the earplugs by pressing down on both the volume up and volume down buttons at the same time while listening to music.
Now, the feeling you'll get when you first come across bone conduction headphones on the internet or in store is that their primary use case is for workouts. And while that is true for a large part, in our opinion, there are a couple of other equally big use cases for these headphones, but more on that later.
The moment you wear either of the AfterShokz headphones, you realize how comfortable they are. Because they sit lightly around your ear, similar to wearing glasses, you almost forget that you're wearing them. Those of us living in warmer climates struggle with over-ears and sometimes in-ears as well. So much hair, so much sweat, we think that bone conduction is the perfect antidote to heat conduction by minimizing skin contact. We do need to say that the more expensive Aeropex is ever so slightly more comfortable than the OpenMove because of a sleeker design. And not to make you self-conscious or anything, but depending on the size of your head, you get the choice between two sizes on the Aeropex, the standard and mini. Unfortunately, the OpenMove only comes in a single size. You only realize you have the headphones on when you lean back and rest your head against something or try to sleep with them on. Due to the headband design, it's not ideal for that. But who knows, this might be a feature and not a bug, since lying down or leaning back isn't exactly the active lifestyle these headphones are designed for.
And speaking of that active lifestyle, the AfterShokz are built to take a beating from the elements, as the Aeropex is rated at IP67, making them waterproof, although they shouldn't be used for swimming, and the OpenMove is IP55 and water resistant. Now, depending on what kind of workouts you do or how active your sweat glands are, you may need a higher IP rating, but one thing to note is that this does impact certain design elements. The OpenMove has a widely available USB Type-C port hidden behind a flap, whereas the Aeropex has a proprietary magnetic charger, which means without the included cable, no conduction will be taking place through your bones. Luckily, however, AfterShokz were thoughtful enough to include two of those cables in the box, just in case you get shocked after losing one of them.
Workouts with these headphones make a lot of sense beyond them being comfortable and water and dust resistant because of three more reasons. One, they just stay in place, which means no more tweaking and fidgeting in the middle of a workout to adjust your earbuds popping out of your ears. Two, the AfterShokz come with a play, pause, skip track button and volume buttons on the headphones, which means you have fewer interruptions to your workout and going for a run outdoors when environment sounds can change. The volume buttons are a huge benefit, which even the most expensive wireless earbuds can sometimes lack. And three, those environment sounds we talked about are actually very important when working out outdoors. So you don't end up shocking more than just your cheekbones. But because your ears are open to ambient noises, it will also mean that you'll notice yourself cranking up the volume when you find yourself in noisy places. And this brings us back to the point we made at the start of the video, that higher volumes are the most dangerous part about any headphones. And also, conspiracy theory guy.
Yeah, dude. I tried bone conduction headphones once and now I have this horn growing out of my head.
And speaking of the two devices we tested, we'd have to give it to the Aeropex again for just being smoother in terms of comfort, vibrations on the cheekbone, and clarity in sound. In terms of controls though, they both do the exact same thing. The AfterShokz are a what you see is what you get kind of device because there is no app. And you know what? Simplicity, it ain't always bad.
So all in all, bone conduction headphones are very suitable for workouts. But what about work? From our testing, these headphones prove to be quite a good option for those of us working from home. Let us explain why. Firstly, the many video calls we make means you need a good microphone, and the AfterShokz do a good job here. For a detailed listen to how they sound on a Zoom or Microsoft Teams call, check out this video, linked above and in the description down below. But the true fuck mount needs to go beyond the microphone only, and the AfterShokz boast a couple of useful features. You adjust volume using the dedicated volume buttons. By pressing down on both of them, you can mute and unmute your mic, and the AfterShokz also support multi-point connections, so they can be connected to your laptop and your phone. In our experience, the multi-point generally worked well, but sometimes needed to be disconnected and reconnected for the connection to work properly. This was done relatively easily by holding down the power button when starting up the headphones, putting them in pairing mode, and connecting to them from your Bluetooth settings.
And going beyond the fuckman, some of you might have families to tend to as well. And since bone conduction headphones leave you aware of your surroundings, you won't be oblivious to any children that may need your attention or the doorbell ringing for an Amazon order for your bone conduction headphones. And if you are interested, do check out the affiliate link in the description for the latest prices. It helps support all our hard work in making videos like this. So bone conduction headphones, yay or nay? Let's just say that these make total sense in three situations. You have a hearing impairment, you work out, or you work from home. It's as simple as that. You don't buy them if you're looking for the best sound quality, loads of customizability, or noise cancelling for obvious reasons.
And our pick between the AfterShokz Aeropex and OpenMove would be the Aeropex due to its more comfortable design, higher water resistance, and longer battery life. But if those don't matter as much for you, then the OpenMove is still a shockingly good choice, and you benefit from the familiar USB Type-C charging port and some extra cash to spare.
You've been pleasantly shocked about bone conduction headphones, and we've been DHRME. Namaste.